Vamos a ver, el hecho que yo sea italiano, vais a ver mucha presencia de Italia, ¿vale? Pero, ¿estáis por ahí? Hola, hola, vale, perfecto. Bueno, entonces. La foto, voglio la foto. Prima, perché dopo non ci picchiamo. Allora, come stava dicendo antes, hablando sempre di sostenibilità e di tutto questo, chicos, por favor, che así progressiamo, perché sennò llegamos tarde. Os recuerdo che è il vino español, entonces se llegamos tarde nos acortan el vino, e io non quiero che nos acorten el vino, ¿vale? Entonces, choqué, ¿no? con esta, no le llamaría startup, le llamaría algo más que startup, ¿vale? Pero con esta empresa italiana, evidentemente con perspectiva no solo italiana, entonces, que cuando me han empezado a explicar el modelo de negocio, cuando me han empezado a explicar lo que estaban haciendo, sobre todo a nivel de datos, y digo, oh, esto es muy interesante, esto lo tengo que traer al Summit, ¿no? Y aquí tengo la suerte de haber convencido a Luca a venir aquí. Bueno, el speech lo harán en inglés también, y es el último en inglés. Luego tenemos Claudio, que aunque sea italiano, habla un castellano, vamos, que parece salido de Malasaña, así que perfecto. Te dejo entonces esto, puedes elegir o estar en el atril o el micrófono. ¿Micrófono rojo funciona? ¿Rojo? Sí. ¿No? ¿O sí o no? Habla, habla, bla, bla. El amarillo, el amarillo. ¿Me abrís algún micrófono? Hola. Amarillo, rojo. Amarillo. Alá, alá, sí. E non andate a spiegare questa cosa. Luca.
Good evening to everybody. Thank you. Thank you very much for this time. Okay. We are a company. We are a strange company because we are a public and private company. Okay, it's called Bus for Fun. I'm here to explain our section, Bus for Fun Business. Bus for Fun is a name for mobility companies born in 2015. The idea was, initially, lots of years ago, to move people, young people, from home to the mass events, concert, football match, Formula One, MotoGP. We faced the COVID, and we stopped our business. Then during the night, we had a meeting. I said, okay, what's going on after the COVID? The idea was people will come back to work in a different way. On this project arrived a public company, called FNM, is the group that managed the mobility trains, buses, metro in Lombardia, Milan area. And now we started to this project. The process of our company is this one. Now we are based in Italy, in Venice. You can come to visit us whatever you want. We have an office in Milan. 1st of May we open in Spain, and next in Switzerland too. Next year we'll be in France. The problem of mobility is this one. You have the mobility here based on a timetable, the classic timetable, trains and buses, but people have different needs that doesn't match the public transport. The idea is to collect the data of the people, the request of people in terms of mobility, and create a mobility system that match the needs. To do this, in Italy we are working, no, we know, but the other guys are working on mass mobility as a service from N point A to N point B. But from an engineering point of view, this will never work from my point of view. The idea was create a mobility as a community, because we need an hashtag for everything, is MAC, mobility as a community. In in Spanish, burbuja, o burbuja. Burbuja de movilidad. Okay. A bubble. But burbuja sounds very, very good. Every one of us has 2-3 burbujas de movilidad. We go to work, we go to the stadium, we go to the gym, probably. This is 96% of our mobility needs. This is the idea. Thanks God, European Community asked us to develop in 2 years this project. We are in a joint JRC in Italy. There are 3 research centers in Europe. We are based in JRC of Ispra. Now, what happened? I come back to the data. If you ask to a mobility company, public mobility company, the data of their passengers in Italy, I'm just talking of Italy, they don't know what they are doing, what the passengers are doing, where they are moving, where they live, where they are going. They know nothing because we have failure in ticketing system, we have failure in the station. You have 1,000 people in the station, but you don't know where they are going because they have a ticket based on year, is a year-based ticket. They don't tap in, tap out. They get in the train, they exit the train, but nobody knows everything. Okay, we started from the company. We approach a company. We have, I don't know, Amazon, for example, or Telecom Italia, your Telefonica. And we ask the address of the home address of the employees. We put this data inside an artificial intelligence created by University of Venice. It's not our. It's a public scientific publication. And the answer is this one. This means that this company, this is a real case, this company has this distribution of people. And the best solution in terms of transportation is that one. Now, this is the best solution, but we have a real trains. The trains based in early 19 tracks. I can share this information, how the algorithm works. And the next step is we take the data from the first company, La Primera Borjuja, then the second company, second Borjuja, and the third one. And this is the result. This is a real case. We have 4 lines, 5 lines, 11 lines. The duration, the passengers, and the aggregation radius. We call them focal point, where people aggregate in order to reach another place. The final effect is this one. Questo era con o senza? Senza. Okay, this is real. It's Rome. Is a famous telecommunication company. This is the distribution of people on the ground, and the effect is this. This is an area without public transport, and now they are connected. We changed completely the system of transportation. Is it clear, or am I clear? Sì o no? Okay, the output of a system is this one, the first output. We have 84% of load factor. Load factor is occupied seat on seat available. The average is 19 minutes on board. But my favorite data is this one. The 80% of people book, because you have to book this service, 1 week before. This means they are planning the mobility 1 week before. And the public company of transportation doesn't know this. This is the input for the next step. The next step is, I show you another real case. This company ed è adesso ho bisogno dell'acqua.
È la verso. Spero che ci sia, se no la vado a cercare.
No. This company had a bus system, a private bus system, like this one. After the analysis, we discovered that nobody uses this part. We increased the lines. This means that the mobility system moved, changed in order to fit the request of the users based on data. We collect the data every day, every 3 months. We run the AI in order to improve the system. The trick is this one. The next trick is this one. We take a transport vehicle, and we have a master company, usually a company with plus 1,000 people. Then we measure the empty seat, and we put another company, a smaller company, on the same bus in order to reduce the emission, in order to increase the load factor. What's going on? This is our network. It's a mix between public trains and private buses in order to move people, workers, from Italy to Switzerland. The policy of Switzerland is very, very easy. We don't want cars. In a few months, you have to cancel the Italian cars from Swiss roads. They call it us and said, okay, you can do it, but from here. This is why we have a company in Switzerland. How it works? There are companies here on the Swiss side, and the employees has a web app, a very easy tool, in which they can use a train, click on train, and receive the tickets. Or use the bus, and they can run on the bus. There is a third button, share the car. Do you know that in Switzerland, the companies pay for private parking lot a tax? It's a funny approach. I have 100 parking lot in my company, inside the company. You have to pay a tax. But not a, it's 30 euro per day. Okay. But the government said, okay, if you company show me that you have a system to reduce the traffic, I pay you. It's a kind of balance. I know that lots of people here works for public institution. This is a very tough approach, but it's working. Because if you don't want to pay, I pay you. Quell'altro non ce l'abbiamo. No. Ok, the final effect of this cross-border transport Italy Swiss, for a single company, we have 558 users. This means that we have 558 cars less on the roads. Easier than I did it. Is based on data. Now we know what they are doing. We don't know the names of the people inside the bus. Absolutely, we know nothing about their name, surname, mobile phone, nothing. We just transport them. That's it. These are the institutions that are helping us. Maybe someone is most famous, or maybe less. Because we pick people from the university in Italy and say to them, okay, try to improve the algorithm and you can share it in, with our institution. Too fast.
I think that it's possible to make a deep focus about the data part because it's very important to understand that all is based
In data.
And raw data, and then you don't have an idea regarding the, you know, perfectly, no numbers, no name of people, but it's important, how can we can catch this data, first part. Second, the algorithm that is inside, and the results.
A guy, Carlos Peña.
Carlos.
Hi, Carlos. You described perfectly our process. I need your presentation for my people. Okay, because the problem here, this is Rome, but you have to extend. The problem is, first, we don't have data. We have to collect on ground the data, but the public does not have data. We are before the silos. I mean, our group is working on a project, a data lake, a huge data lake called, in parallel, called Project Darwin, in which they are starting from the telephone data, the cellular phone data, but there was a girl here of Telefonica, we discussed it during somewhere. It's not enough to create the mobility system. The second one is in Milan area, for example, there are 5 different ticketing systems. This means that the 5 silos don't talk to each other. This is why we start from scratch. The data is growing. The question is, can we mix the data? Yes, because we are using public data of trains, the timetable. I show you. Here, we are using a mix of trains and buses. We control the buses, but we don't control the train. This is why the system is fed by public data of the region, the timetable of the trains, the data from the ticketing, and the data collected on board. Because the user has to book the run. Another small trick. Based on data, the reservation system closed 48 hours before the run. This means that today you can book only Monday. If there are a few people, because the company is on a hybrid scheme like Telecom Italia, the customers in Telecom Italia, they don't work Friday. No, they work Friday by at home. They don't move from home to the office. We reduce the size of the buses. We don't use a 50 seats. We use a 16 seats. This kind of planning reduces the final impact of the... I'm answering or... This collection data is very, very powerful. This means another small company without any data and without the power to collect data, because if you are 50 people, you don't have the power to create this kind of system, can use the same mobility system of a larger company. We call them the master company. We ask to the big companies in Italy to be part of this process for social responsibility. Because for a huge bank, a huge telephonic company, is not, okay, non mi viene in inglese, big blue collar company, for them, 1 million per year is not a problem. But they start the process, we give back money. This step is very, very important. We sell the empty seat to the small companies, but the money coming back is used to increase the mobility system. The 25,000 euro per month are used to create a new lines. Question. I know that you have a question.
I live in Milan where
okay.
5 different ticketing, but we pay ticket. In Rome, I'm not
no.
sure about
it. No, okay. No, this is another problem.
But how you manage in a city like Rome, where so many tourists and people coming from outside and probably are not using it?
No, they cannot. No, the system is in bubble. This is a private service. Okay, we don't create a parallel service to the public transportation because first is illegal. Second is not necessary because the public transportation system is paid by our taxes, and we have to maximize. The problem is for a company like Trenord. Trenord is the owner of the public service, the railway public service in the Milan region. The problem is, I want to change the timetable. Okay, perfect. How? Because I have no idea about the mobility request. Everybody complains because the train is full, the train is late, the train is whatever you want. But you don't have any data. This is why this line. This one. The first train is 5:10 in the morning. But the shift in Mendrisio for the huge watch company is 6. Nobody can use that train. The first shift of the day is not covered by the train. Absolutely not. Then we have a bus. Okay, you can go by train, inbound in train, outbound by bus, or vice versa. Question about ESG. Okay, to the end of process, we take all the data in a raw format, Excel, and we push to the company the data. Because my favorite example is this one, because we apply the same technology for sport events. You have San Siro Stadium, is under our control in terms of data. You have 80,000 people, more or less, every given Sunday, and every given Champions League match, like yesterday or 2 days ago, that move and collapse in a small area. Okay, managing in this way the stadium, the time for fill the stadium passed by 3 hours and 40 minutes of mess in 1 hour and 20 minutes of relative quiet, relative, because it's not so easy. 80,000 people. Do you know this? You are not understanding, or?
But I understand.
Okay. In the same process of ESG for a football match is this one. We've spoken with lots of Spanish football team. They are focused ESG on the grass. The grass is perfect. Few waters, everything is perfect. The light is perfect, LED everywhere. The glasses for the beer, perfect. But 80,000 people that arrives from 200 kilometers far away is out of control. Okay, we are very focused on mobility. Huh? Mobility is not the end of life, but we use the same technology for football match, big concert like Harry Styles in Reggio Emilia. We discussed 100,000 people. That for we are open to share the European community asked us two things. The first one, to share the business model and eventually the algorithm, and the second one, to share the data. We are here to do it.
Perfect. Thank you.
Muchas gracias. Grazie. Thank you. Thank you.
Ahí tiene la mochila del friki, o sea que esta también hay que hacer endorsement en LinkedIn y estas cosas así. Bueno, gracias. Bueno.